Moi, j'attends mon passage, j'attends le dernier virage. Je bois sans t'oublier, je bois pour m'oublier. Je veux garder ton image comme une fusée dans les nuages.
Voilà, a father, reading the lyrics of a song dedicated to his son, Stéphane. He was murdered at the age of 39 during the Bataclan attacks. The lyrics were written by the musician Captain Boogie. He too was at the concert hall on the evening of the 13th of November 2015 and was one of the last people to see Stéphane alive. Jean-Pierre included the lyrics of the song in his book, which he wrote to try and find answers to the tragedy, for himself, as well as for his 10-year-old grandson, Stéphane's child.
Il sait que son père est mort, mais il sait rien. C'est assez compliqué à expliquer. Mais si un jour il pose des questions, il aura un document qui permet de comprendre un peu le contexte.
At first, Jean-Pierre was reluctant to join the trial as a civil party, but he then decided to do so. The trial will be a massive undertaking and 14 defendants will appear.
Que les accusés prennent 20 ans, 30 ans ou perpétuité, ça ne changera pas notre quotidien et ça ne fera pas revenir Stéphane. Mais il y a quand même un deuxième enjeu qui résulte quand même de l'instruction, qui va démontrer les rouages de ce carnage. Quelles sont les personnes qui, à l'étranger, ont développé l'idéologie mortifère. Ça permettra, outre de comprendre ce qui s'est passé cette fois-là, mais bien sûr d'éviter que ça se reproduise.
8 months after the tragic November night in Paris, another terrorist attack took place in the southern city of Nice, where Jean-Pierre now lives for part of the year. He lives close to the Promenade des Anglais, where the rampage took place. And it is here that he participates in group discussions with other victims.